Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Final Fantasy Tactics War of the Lions. Let's go ahead and head into the next level, the Palings. Okay, so this is another interesting map in that all of the treasures to find, right here. These four. So again, I don't think there's a real issue with standing on them, but we'll find out. Altair gets there. Rafa can go right there. And Agrius there. I did get her another ability. She had enough points. So I figured, why not? I don't know what I'll do with her when she finishes that class. The Palings. These look like vampire cats. Objective, defeat all enemies. Commence! And, I did it. She has two Excaliburs. We'll see how effective that really is. It probably isn't going to be effective. Which, I can never remember which button it is that should, there it is. Okay, so we've got walls in between. Otherwise, it's basically a W shape. See a couple of behemoths and a lot of vampire cats. When it's his turn, I'll go over where all the things are, but for now, we're all on level 5. There's a level 5 there. So I should take a quick look at the unit list. So on all of these levels, there's a chance to encounter humans. As we saw in the last one, there were 3. I'm not being very lucky with that. Phobos the Behemoth with 768 hit points and level 85. Eupalomos. Polycaon. Not sure if we've seen vampire cats. A nimble quadruped that hunts using its sharp teeth, the fluid covering its fangs and claws causes status effects. Weakness to earth. And of course, I have gotten rid of Balthier from being a monk. Oh well. Counter and ignore elevation. Cannot enter water. Weakness earth. And blaster. We got cat scratch. Attack with a powerful kick. At least it's not 4 times damage like it is in Final Fantasy VI. And attack by releasing luminous energy. Effect stone and stop. I think we can still be affected by that. And then a coral with Venom Fang. So, Polycaon the Vampire Cat. Chessius the Vampire Cat. Inferi the Vampire Cat. Solomus the Coral. Hylus the Vampire Cat, Oxalos the Vampire Cat, and then back to me. Alright. Well, I think I'm going to want to stay on 5, if I can. So, let's just go ahead and put her here. Let's see what we can do. So, I got Abyssal Blade, which is cone-shaped, so makes this T-shape here. So I could hit that. I think this is going to drain hit points to do that, though, so let's hold off on that. That does more damage anyway. Boop. What geomancy abilities can I do? I can bring them through the wall. 208 damage. Holy cow. Yeah, sure. Let's do it. You gained a job level. He's not going to be in this class for very long because it's not exactly a very expensive to master class. Let's move. Found some ninja gear. I'll just put regen on Eagle Claw there. Alright, so we've got our bard song. So 37 turns is when it would happen. Let's see. So that would be Eagle Claw would be able to move, and Ald would be able to move. Ald and Eagle Claw again. And finally. Finally, we'd get Finale. It's really not good. If I had the thing that reduces charge time, maybe it would be pretty good. Re-raise, regen, protect, shell, and haste. I will do one of this, even though, again, that's 16. He will move before it goes. But just being able to put all of that on our people would be pretty good. Just gonna get off these tiles here. Okay, so I can hit them. Let's actually see what everyone else is on. So you're on 4. You're on 2. You're on 2. 0, 0, 1, and 0. Alright. And I forgot to take a look to see where everything is. Alright, well, I'll do that next time. We'll try stopping them. There we go. One of them is stopped. Two of them are stopped. Very nice. So I'm going to hope that we get a lot of crystallizations here, but not really counting on it. There's a lot of enemies, though, so there's a pretty good chance. There's no real reason for me to keep anything around, either. Get that regen going, just because. So, basically, like, any spell or ability that takes longer to get off than the character has a turn, it's not worth it. It's really, really not worth it. And it's kind of unfortunate, but it is true. You know what? I am going to try out this new ability. Abyssal Blade, because it'll hit... Oh. That's a little bit bigger area of effect than I expected. Oh. Huh. I guess because of my positioning, it just didn't look like it was going to be that big. It goes through walls. Well, that's pretty good. ...64 damage. Not too bad. Only 88 damage on that guy, unfortunately. Found an elixir. I should have had her cast something. Oh well. She'll get her turn that much faster. Okay, going up to attack Balthier. Nice block. We're going to do Blaster. Excellent. It's kind of funny how he's... The armor that he came with at the beginning of the game... Well, not at the beginning of the game, but when we first got him. He has not taken off. Alright, so, in terms of the exits, first potential exit is right there at the end of this little outcropping. Next one is where this guy is. And then third one is there. One is there, and one is right there. Alright, so. Given that, you're immune to stop. You are not immune to stop. Disable. Just disable that entire line of enemies. Let's try it. Ah, feels good. Very nice. That said, I think that I will move... No, I will wait. Because I'm going to need to do something to that guy. Nameless Song. It missed on Balthier, unfortunately. Eagle Claw gained a job level. Alright, so let's see. Rend speed, zero per- oh, it doesn't go through walls, right. Found a cursed ring. Should cast something. Oh well. Okay, so that song... It did random effects. I did not realize that. This unit is reciting poetry or dancing. So he did get hasted, but... Oh, good. Oh, think I will probably have you stay back here and, focus on keeping this guy from doing anything. I think being on 6 is gonna be wise now. Height, prime. And just keep up the hesitation. Now they may end up standing on tiles that I need to get onto, but we'll see. Run away! Okay, that guy's gonna keep advancing, though. That guy's gonna run! Only 53% chance to hit, though. Ugh. Don't miss. I'm not actually sure which tile I have not been on. I think it's this one? No. There we go, found blaster. That's the one that I haven't been on. So he's not stopped anymore. He's gonna try blastering Eagle Claw. Good. All right, let's arm shot you. There we go. So that spot does not have a... she's actually going to be in kind of some trouble there, actually. She didn't get healed after using the darkness attack. Decreases speed a bit. Height of prime. And hesitation. It's just the one guy, but that's okay. I'm gonna run out of targets for that all to find other other ways to target them. Gained a level 70 now. Dang it, you're in the wrong place. Sure, go ahead and protect all rend your speed some more. Now he's getting job points there. Hmm. Don't know. Yeah. Just kind of like derped on what was going on or something. I don't know. Anyway, let's see. 713, 66, 83. I guess I could go with level 3. I don't think any of our people are level 3. Yeah, but you guys should actually. No, you do have a thief's cap. Okay. So I can disable you. There we go. Anytime you want to go, Agrius, that'd be fine with me. He's not gonna die to this, but I mean, we just did a casual 630 points of damage. I'm pretty good with that. I'm pretty happy about that. Oh god, let me get behind her. Maybe she won't see me. Obviously, the healing ones would be pretty good, but I don't think they would oftentimes have the effect that I want. The MP one might, as long as people keep using them. Keeping immobilized. Like, I mean, as long as Rafa keeps casting spells and stuff. Polycaon disappeared, leaving behind a treasure chest. Can't get the treasure chest. Alright. Bard song. That's, hit points. Oh, I didn't get the MP1. Right, right. Oh, let's just do the battle chant. I probably reduce this guy's speed enough. Not really. It's still pretty fast. I feel almost bad just controlling the battlefield as much as I do. Especially when so many of the enemies in these fights are higher level than I am. There goes regen. That's fine. Hello! Oh look, you're dead. It's a little unfortunate. That's gonna be dangerous. It's really dangerous. Because it was enough to kill her. Balthier gained a job level. We'll get the treasure chest. X potion! Not bad. Alright, hopefully her turn hasn't come yet. It has not. Good. Alright, level 3, XP 3, and CT 4. Those would all work. Yeah, CT 4 would be bad. level 3. That would bring back two things. That would not be great. XP. 3. That would bring one back. Better bring back one than all of them. Alright, arise. Figure another way to take care of the coral. Unfortunately, the coral is going to move very soon. Battle chant! Hey, Agrius, I heard you want to do more damage. Now that's just mean. Of course, now the thing's gonna get protected too. No, it doesn't, because it's down a level, right? Hey, I heard you liked getting swords to the face. Shoot. One is Eupalamos. Well, poop. Guess I'm gonna have to bring her back to life again. Agrius, it was nice knowing you. I'll bring you back again. That's one of the big problems. She's not quite a glass cannon, but she's very much a glass cannon. Her XP is still 6.3. So is that guy's. Well. Hey, Balthier, I heard you liked fighting that thing. Get back on your feet, Agrius. All gained a job level. Oxylos disappeared, leaving behind a crystal. Inferi disappeared, leaving behind a treasure chest. Well, Balthier is going to do more damage. Get dead. Claw Rafa. Ow. Her shell disappeared. Just do some damage. Well, not that you needed it. In fact, Rafa could have used it herself, but it's okay. Alright, someone is a very bad kitty. Very bad kitty. Let's see. You have XP Prime might work. Okay, I like that. Let's go down to the Time Magics for Immobilize. Not the exit there. Divine Ruination. 338. Almost enough to kill. Oh, hey! Got a critical. Agri's gained a level. I'll take that. Go to Life's Anthem. That'll still help her. There's really nothing else to do at the moment. Dang it! Oh, come on! Wasn't even that far. You. Let's keep you disabled, please. Well, that's really not that many hit points, actually. Eagle Claw gained a level. Alright, so no exit there. Let's keep going down here. Dang it. Phobos disappeared, leaving behind a crystal. Gets a little bit brighter in here. Let's go over towards those treasure chests. Balthier gained a level. Kitty's doing nothing. Because he can't. Rafa gained a level. Okay, let's try this spot first. Nope. Come on, 55% chance. There we go. And got a maiden's kiss. Keep you immobilized. Oh, you actually higher level. Oh, you're actually higher level than him now. It's actually pretty good. I'd rather keep a low level one under control. From gaining too many experience points. Alright. That should be this one then. I didn't actually have anyone stand there. Dang it. Alright. There we go. Keep decreasing his speed. Really a fan of the way the books and harps work. Like, people one and two spaces away from you can't hear the harp or something. I mean, it's not a great weapon. It really isn't. Give it the full 3 radius range. Yeah, whatever. So we've got two corpses that are about to crystallize. Wow, Rafa. There we go. Found a passage leading deeper. About time. Treasure chest. There we go. Gained a job level. Treasure chest. Echo herbs. Yay. Echo herbs. Items that I've never used. Like, I kind of feel like items should be a fixed command. Sure, you could, you know, unlock different things beyond potion with the chemist class. That would be good. But, like, there's no reason to ever take items for the most part. Not no reason. Sometimes it is, you know, you always want to have two people who can bring people back to life, basically. It's okay with one if you're, like, absolutely sure that that one person is never going to be in danger and they have range. Like, Ald with arithmetic skill, keeping him all the way back, it's not a problem. You know, I don't need other people who can bring characters back to life when in that situation, generally. You know, obviously you want to save first and everything, but... Like, let us always have the item command or something. I also kind of feel like the, a lot of the secondary abilities should automatically be added to the class. Automatically be added to the classes as you, master them and stuff. Maiden's Kiss, yay. There's just, like, no reason to, there's no real good reason to master classes in this game. Other than just saying, hey, I mastered these classes. It does help Onion Knight, but the Onion Knight really isn't good because, you can't use the JP that you gain. I mean, if you're really happy with the way someone is built, then yeah, I mean, I guess you can just leave them as that class and not worry about the job points. But anyway, so this is the map. It's a little bit easier to see this side than turning it all the way around here. Light seems to be coming from the bottom. But it's essentially like a W shape. You know, it comes around here, and then here, over here, over here, and then down here. So, still pretty neat. I don't dislike the maps in this. I just like the maps in Tactics Ogre a lot better. Like, so what I would say is that the way that the job system operates in this game, better than Tactics Ogre. The way the maps operate, and this, you know, the way that the battle actually flows, is better in Tactics Ogre. Well. Hey, Rafa, you want to get the kill? Bonk. Hit him with your purse. It's impossible to not compare this game to Tactics Ogre if you've played them both, because they're both made by the same teams. And they're very, very similar. 55,400 gil. Story-wise, what I would say about Tactics Ogre, I mean, to be perfectly honest, I would put them both as fantastic stories. Tactics Ogre's advantage is the branching storyline, which they specifically didn't want to do in this game because they felt it was confusing and stuff like that. And I get it, but that was a pretty cool concept. Alright, let's see. A summoner. Let's get Lich. I get another bard song. Drowsy Melody. Eagle Claw. You can get the last of the Bard Song, Seraph Song. There we go. And you do not have enough to get anything else. Definitely not going to leave you in this class long enough to get Fly. Probably not really to get any of the other things. I think I might leave you in long enough to get Move Plus 3, but if I even do that, I might bring some other people. In fact, it might be fun to bring Nancy along as a dancer. So I think she can become a dancer. It's So then we can see, you know, the differences between the classes and stuff like that. Yeah, 300 more points and he's already mastered Geomancer. I think he's picked up a few abilities, so... Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of wasted job points with the Geomancer, and I don't get it. It's, rather annoying. You know, whereas you've got classes like, Ninja, which 4,000 to master, Samurai, which he doesn't have, takes similar amounts to master. Oops. Wrong button. Let's go ahead and get Kiraja. Just because we can. Agrius. Need 1,200 for that last ability. I don't know that I'll go for HP boost. But the leveling in this class is probably not too bad, so might be worth sticking with it for a little bit. That said, as fun as it was, oops, not job. I'm not gonna have her dual wield. I want JP boost. Interesting choice there. So the blaster, a firearm that shoots electrically charged bullets, attack 22, element lightning. Compare that to the other elemental guns. I must have passed them. Yeah, there we go. Blaze gun and glacial gun. 21 for the blaze, 20 for the glacial gun. So it is better. And the Ramondan pistol is 6. Mithril gun is 8. Ross Algethi is 12. It's this big, big jump between the Mithril and Ramondan gun. Ross Algethi is, of course, added to this game for Valtir. But then you get up to the... You know, you go from... What, 8? Up to 20 on the glacial gun when you get that. It's pretty crazy. Long range, too. Guns are really good in this game. Excalibur. Let's go ahead and grab the, Escutcheon. And rather than the circlet, get you back on the ribbon. That does mean that Rhys can have the other Excalibur. All right. I might make him an orator when he's done, in part because he'd be able to equip a gun. That'd be pretty good, especially with that blaze gun. So, when we come back next time, we'll delve deeper into Midlight's Deep. See you then, everyone.